Hi everyone, it's Sean. Today's video is on resolving design conflicts. This is a video I've wanted to do for some time, but I wasn't really sure how to handle it, and I think I've kind of got my method now. It's an abstract subject. It's not going to be real obvious to understand how this applies until we get to the end of the video. I'll show you an example, but the principle I'm going to describe and go through in the beginning is going to seem really obvious, but it's not so obvious once you get into the design process. And I wanted to kind of help you see that when you've got a layout that's not working, you like the color, you like the photo, you like the font, but for some reason it's not working and you can't understand why, and you ditch the layout and start over again, that maybe you were hasty. And you'll see that there's ways that things work that maybe aren't quite so obvious. So let's get down to it and I'll show you what I mean. So in this InDesign file, I've got four photos. It's the same model in each photo, which I'm going to show you. And so I want you to look at these photos and think for a moment. There's four of them. Just kind of think as you see them, what word would you associate with this photo? What word would you associate with this one? With this one? And with this one? And by that I mean, you know, these photos are obviously of the same model. They are all portraits, but there's something different about each one of them. And so if you have your head around that, I'll show you how I've kind of differentiated the photos, and this will become important as we go. So the first photo, I'm going to say, looks comfortable. She's in a sweater, she sort of has a very casual body language, and she looks kind of like she's possibly sitting at home or in a very relaxed kind of state. So comfortable is a word I'll use. The word I'll use here, however, is confident. Now, same model, same clothes, slightly different posture, different expression, it changes things. This one, same girl, different outfit, obviously, slightly different hair and kind of makeup, and obviously the look on her face is different. So this one's kind of more, I'll call it intense, for a lack of a better word. And finally, this one, it's a little sexier. So these are four different images of the same model that have different tone and feeling. So then what does design conflict mean in relation to images and type and all those things? Well, let's kind of take a look at each one of these photos in a different example so I can kind of talk to you about what I'm getting at with design conflict. So the first model image with these color bars, this is not a layout, but this could be the foundation for one. This might be a website. Those color blocks could be buttons. Things of that nature. But if you look at these, there's entirely nothing wrong, and if I sort of move the image out of the way for a second, there's nothing wrong with any one of these colors. Now, they don't necessarily work together very well, but the reality is these colors aren't bad colors. You could use any one of these anytime in any design. They're perfectly fine. And yet, when I see them over this image, I have several problems. The blue is in conflict overall, even though the red in this photo is influenced by blue, it doesn't work with blue. The other red beneath it, the second color, this one is too close to the background but doesn't have its principal coolness to it. So that's in conflict. Green and red are complementary, but it's certainly not working between these greens and reds. This color doesn't support that background or anything in her face or clothing, and the gray seems kind of dark. So, you know, that's obvious, but when you look at this and you say, okay, well then what are the right colors potentially? Well, then these colors tend to pick up on what's actually happening in the image. There's colors that are complementary to kind of the overall look and feel. So with a simple color shift, this page looks strange, this one not so much. And there's no layout change, there's simply a color change. And that's an important distinction to make. And I'll move on to the next example so you can kind of see where I'm going with all of this. So I have this now confident photo. I identified it as confident. And so I have Jane Smith. She's the president and CEO of National Bank, Inc., which is, of course, something I just made up. But when you look at this, you're sort of like, well, there's something kind of not working here. And there's nothing wrong with this font. I've actually used this font several times. But when I look at this font, I look at the treatment of Jane Smith, President and CEO, National Bank, Inc. I'm not feeling it. Somehow there's something here that's not right. But the only thing is the choice of font. And so I've reset Jane Smith, President and CEO, So this is something I expect a lot more to see. So the choice of font makes a big difference. But does that mean that this font is wrong? Well, not necessarily, because if I put that same font in this context, so Jane Smith, author and artist, comfy photo, warm color, suddenly this font works perfectly fine. So it isn't that the font was wrong, nor is it that the image was wrong. It's the combination of the two that was wrong. And that's a really important part of this that I want to get a little more into as we go. So similarly, if I take what I'll call the intense photo, and I have just some fake Greek copy in the right side, but I look at this image and I look at that copy arrangement, and this one's a little less obvious as to what the problem could or could not be if you're struggling with this combination. There's nothing wrong with centered text. The text is placed a little bit off of the third, but not in an unpleasant location. It's not in conflict with the image, but why is there a design conflict here? Well, the design conflict may exist because, in contrast to something like this, where I've taken her intense expression and I've put type in an intense kind of stressed out way in front of her face, and all I can see now is her eyes. As soon as I look at this page, I'm drawn right to her eyes. And then the copy around that is unusually presented. I can read it, it's fine, but now I'm getting this uncomfortable feeling from the layout. That intensity is maybe delivered a little more than this intensity. And if I chose this photo because it was intense, then it would argue that I should take it all the way. So this layout may not be supporting that as much. But now, is that the only thing? Well, not necessarily, because if I change the photo, you would think the same principle would apply, but it really doesn't. This photo, low resolution at this size, but you get the point that the photo of her smiling and more confident doesn't make sense with this. Suddenly I'm struggling because it isn't intense, now it just doesn't work. But here, this works perfectly fine. So the elements themselves are not wrong, and this is a real mind freak when you're working on stuff. You'll look at things and go, "No, man, this font looks good. You know, I've got it set properly. What is not working here?" Sometimes it's these kinds of connections. So in this image, she has a sexy look about her and the sexy type on the right side. Once again, nothing wrong with this layout. Is she sexy? Sure. I didn't change anything. I didn't make it worse by just putting the type on the side. It doesn't affect in any way. However, if I go to this example, and I've taken the word sexy and I've made it a little bit of a different type arrangement, and obviously chosen a different kind of font, but I've also taken her photo and I've done a little bit of Photoshop work, which is not perfect, but I want you to understand the point, not necessarily what I did. The point of it is that I softened the edges, I added a lot more glow to her skin, and I darkened the area around her eyes and her upper lip. And I did that because I'm trying to accentuate her features. So in contrast, she looks perfectly fine here, but when you go to this treatment of the image, she sort of comes to life a little more. So in this case, it's even a more abstract connection because there was nothing wrong with this photo. And in fact, I could take this copy and I could delete this one and paste this one in its place. And it still works just fine. So now the only thing that was affecting the message was just the treatment of the photo, not even the layout, not even the type. So that's another level that may have been harder to see if you're not thinking that way. And so the point of all these things that I'm getting at, and I'll just back up to the beginning of my document here, is that when I looked at this image, I made a decision right away that this image was a soft, kind of comfortable, warm photo of this girl, which was not necessarily professional looking, though it's professionally photographed. She doesn't look like she's ready to take a big meeting. You know, she doesn't look like she's in stress. And so I had to identify that to really know when is it right to use this photo. Same with this one. She doesn't look like she's at home, even though she might be, but she looks like somebody who you're just getting ready to interview, or she's just getting ready to deliver her speech to her employees. She has a confidence about her that when I look at the photo, I have to determine that so that I know if I'm going to have a conflict. Because I'm not going to use this photo. If this woman in this photo was a veterinarian, I wouldn't use this image on her website because it would make no sense whatsoever. I would use this one, and I might use this one. but I'm not going to use this one, and I'm not going to use this one. And by the same token, if she was a model looking for work as a lingerie model, I would not put this on her website because this image wouldn't make as much sense. Perfectly good image, perfectly good design, but it wouldn't make the same sense this image does. And as you progress through these elements, you can see that these design conflicts can creep up if you're not paying attention to those relationships. Now, this is kind of an abstract concept again, and I've shown you some really duh kind of examples. But let me show you something a little less intuitive, and hopefully this will give you an idea where all this is going. So if you remember this layout that I did for a couple of videos back, the website building against a grid, well, let's ignore the grid, let's ignore all those things for this purpose. Let's just talk about the layout. Let's just talk about the tone and feeling that's been created. So if you remember, Supinder is a model and an actress and a TV host, a real one. This is, of course, a fake website, but the point is that everything here has a nice balance. There's nice open white space. There's a fresh blue color to contrast, sort of the warmness in her clothing here. And there's no harsh blacks other than a couple of headings and that big sort of navigational button there. So this balance works really well, and I'm really quite happy with how this went. But now if I make one subtle change to the color, no layout change, no font change, no image change, nothing. I've only changed the color. And by changing the color, I've changed the entire feeling of this. By just adding this red, and I've made these read mores now a more standard navigation blue. Whoops. A more standard navigation blue that you would see if you didn't specifically tell your CSS code that you wanted a specific color. It would give you this random kind of blue that is a default color. And if I had just left it that way, the layout hasn't changed at all, but it works a lot less well than this does, in my opinion. Now, you can argue that you prefer the red. That's not what this video is about. It's not about whose opinion is right about a layout. The point I'm making is that if I had done this and I had used red, I may have gotten to this point and gone, man, this layout is just not working the way I thought it was going to. And the reason isn't a big one. I end up dumping the layout because I'm frustrated. But in reality, if I had made two clicks and two changes, I could have saved the entire thing. And then I'll go even further and just show you this example, which is the same red, but now I've changed the font. The lead font is now this sort of more decorative headline font with these spatter patterns around it. Nice font. I've used this before in POP. There's nothing wrong with it. And this is the body copy now is in Minion, which is a serif font. Nothing wrong with it. I've used Minion too. It's a good font. But now suddenly, it's just not working the same way that this is working. And this meets my intentions, but these other ones don't. And if I'm struggling with why that is, it's important to know what things to look for. Sometimes the fonts are the conflict because the font doesn't match the image. And it can be just that simple. And other times the image tone isn't the right one. You've got six different images you could have used. You use the one that just didn't seem to fit. But if you don't know why it fits or why it doesn't fit, it becomes harder to see these things. So going back to my original images, once again, having said all of that, if you can kind of see where I'm getting at now, this image, this image, this image, this image, and different fonts, different colors, how those can create conflicts if you're not sure what to look for. So before you ditch your layouts that aren't working, take a step back and look at the elements themselves. They may be the problem, not your layout, not the choices you've made. You may just switch out a photo and fix the entire thing without having to start over again, without losing all the work that you've done. So it's sort of a strange area of design and a weird headspace to be in, but I hope this kind of made sense to you. And there's no lapse time design after this because there wasn't really any creative that I did. But anyway, hopefully this made sense, and more videos will be coming soon. So feel free to comment, like or dislike, and give me suggestions if you have a different opinion about this. But design conflicts are easy to resolve, not so easy to see. But hopefully that helps you, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.